This is what these Ash'ari.
It's not concise. Exactly.
So, for example, if you have studied Ash'ari Aqidah, you would have studied something like As-Sanusiyya or Nasafi's Creed.
Yes.
You would have studied Laqani's Jawharat al-Tawheed. You would have studied those things in detail. But those things are based, as you know, on the kalam of a lot of the time of Juwayni and his irshad. But now the question is al-Juwayni's irshad, is that consistent with now the pre-Ash'aris, the Hadith al-Muhasibi and Ibn Kulab?
The argument is that the early Ash'aris, who let's say made Tafwid al-Ma'na, and then the later ones who might have adopted giving a meaning. However, there were early ones and later ones that did the exact opposite as well, right? So, of course, let's say the Ash'aris differed in many certain things. However, they've all agreed upon negating the fact that Allah has a physical limb.
Yeah, and so have the Atharis and the Hanbalis.
So is that your position?
Yes.
So Allah does not have
a limb? No, no one says that Allah is physical from the Muslims.
Okay, let me thank you. That's all I wanted to hear. I have no need to discuss with you. If you believe Allah's hand's not physical.
No. The word physical is something which no one has said. Here's what we say.
When they say the ma'na of yet means the hand that we all know, a hand that grabs, is that not a physical
I understand this. I understand your concern here. I get it. Mm. But here's what I'll say now. No one says the word physical. What they say, like let's be frank and open, yeah? Let's use the most common example, which is Ulu. Okay, let's use Ulu. Let's say, Aina Allah, where is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Okay, now, the Ash'ari creed, would you say that there's one answer within the Ash'aris into that question? Laysa lahu makanan aw zaman. Would you say that that's the standard answer?
I would say so, yes.
I would say that's false, and I'll give you the evidence for this right now, okay? As we said before, Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari, he's written a book called Ibana, which is disputed. I'm not going to go into it, you know why? Because I know it's going to be kalam, a manuscript, al-Makhtuta, has it been miscatalogued? Is it been mansuba to him when it's not mansuba? I'm not going to go into kalam. However, I could say that his students, like he had a student called al-Tabari, not al-Tabari, obviously Abu Jarir al-Tabari, who did do naql of his kalam in Ibana, which was concurrent with the nuskha that we have. I'm not going to go into the, he got a book called Maqalat al-Islamiyin. In his book, Al-Maqalat al-Islamiyin, he talks about Ahl al-Hadith al-Athar, or Ahl al-Hadith, and he says that this was the firqa, the correct one, and so on, and they say he does ithbat. On the issue of Ulu now, if we go to Al-Harith al-Muhasibi and Ibn Kulab, what do they say about Ulu? They do ithbat of Ulu, and they use different words than that of Surah al-Taha. For example, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ar-Rahman wa ala arsh istawa. They don't use those kalam, they use other words. Yeah, يعني مثلا they use قوله تعالى يصعد إليه يصعد الكلم الطيب. Yeah, so they use that to do إثبات of كلام. Now it's not تفويد, because if it was تفويد, they would have to use exactly the same كلام. Now, so for example, Al-Harith al-Muhasibi and Ibn Kulam. Al-Harith al-Muhasibi has a kitab called فهم القرآن, and in it he says that Allah is فوق عرشه بائن من خلقه. اسمع بائن من خلقه. He didn't say الرحمن على العرش استوى, which would be تفويد, because تفويد you have to use the same كلام. الحارث المحاسب. Now listen to this, very important. Now Abu Bakr al-Baqillani has a book called التمهيد. You must be aware of this book. Yes,
part of the book, but I haven't read.
Okay, you came and you said, yeah, you said
I might have not read the book.
Very important kitab. It's a precursor to the Ghazali's books, because obviously al-Baqillani came before al-Juwayni. By the way, I read a lot of Ash'ari stuff, yeah?
I'm aware.
So. Abu Bakr al-Baqillani wrote a book called Tamheed. Now, we had the Makhtuta, which is a manuscript of Tamheed, that Al-Kawthari, yeah? Al-Kawthari, he did Nafi. Listen to this very importantly. Al-Kawthari, who was like contemporary, 100 years or whatever it was, 70, 90, I don't know how many years ago, he said that, because there's Aqwal of Ibn Taymiyyah and those guys saying that Abu Bakr al-Baqillani said Allah is above his throne. That's what he says. Now, Ibn Taymiyyah is saying Allah is above his throne. Obviously that's his position. He's saying that he's doing naql of who? He's doing naql of Abu Bakr al-Baqillani, saying that he's the closest to us, because he says Allah is above his throne in what? Tamheed. The Makhtuta, the manuscript that was gotten now from Tamheed, has in it that Abu Bakr al-Baqillani says that Allah is فوق عرشه, etc, etc, etc. This is not just, so the Ash'ari movement, the early Ash'aira, in my opinion, they had a different understanding of Isma' al-Sifat than those who came after them. And likewise, some Hanabila, like Abu Ya'la and Ibn Aqil, had very tafwidi, or you could call it even ta'wili type tendencies. So the issue is not, here's what the Asri say, yeah, and here's what the Ash'ari say. The issue is this, what did the Salaf say? Because my argument will be this. Now you must have read, yes, you must have read Khalq Af'al al-Abad by al-Bukhari. Al-Bukhari wrote a book, he done jama' of all the kalam. Listen to this very important kalam, yeah? Al-Bukhari, the Ummah has yani agreed upon al-Bukhari. He's got a book called Khalq Af'al al-Ibad.
Well, what do you mean by agree?
Yani in that he's not someone of deviancy, yes?
Oh, yes, yes.
Khalas. So no one will say that Bukhari is a deviant. He's Sunni. Now, what is his position of where is Allah? A very important question. He brings aqwal in Khalq Af'al al-Ibad of the Salaf, Sufyan al-Thawri and blah, 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 all of them saying that Allah is above his throne.
Yeah.
Okay.
I would say the exact same thing. Allah is above his throne.
Yes. But he uses different words. Ha. Very important. So he doesn't say the same lafz of the Quran, which is Ar-Rahman wa ala al-Arsh istawa, etc. Because that would be tafweed. Akramakum Allah. But this is not tafweed because he's using the. Now that when the Salaf did this, they use different words. So they say something like, Ilayhi yas'adu al-kalimu al-tayyibu. Or they would say the fact that Allah ba'inun min khalqihi, fawqa arshihi. Ha. Bidatihi, all this kalam is in there. So in Khalq Af'al al-Ibad by al-Bukhari, he puts together this kalam which says on Alu, because there's two things. Why did Bukhari write that book? Bukhari wrote that book because he wanted to show what his aqidah was, because people were accusing him of being like, saying that the Quran is created, etc. He's saying, no, I don't believe in that. I'm with Ahmed and this is my belief. So he wanted to what? To legitimize his Sunnism, if you like. And align himself with Ahmed, and he wrote this book as a compilation of Aqwal. Now you could ask the question, what are the narrations? Why Bukhari collated it? Bukhari is the best muhaddith of all time. So his narrations are going to be sahih. And moreover, you don't need
the tahdith. Would you say that every hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari is sahih?
No, because there's mu'allaqat and certain kalam and dalakutni. But here's the difference. Sorry to cut you off. The difference is that Bukhari was mentioning his contemporaries. The difference is that Bukhari is talking about people that lived in his time.
Yeah.
The difference is that when Bukhari, you can't have mu'allaq, because you know, the issue with Bukhari is mu'allaqat, yeah? Which, by the way, Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani done a wasl of it. There's a book that Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, for example, the hadith of music, sorry to be controversial, but لَيَكُونَنَّ أَقْوَامًا لِيَسْتَحِلُّ الْحِرَ وَالْحَرِيرُ وَالْخَمْرُ الْمَعَازِفُ. Hadith very well known. There's going to be people of you that are going to do halal, do istihlal of something which is halal, not haram.
Yeah.
And he mentions four things. One of them is ma'azif music. So Al-Ghazaliyu and Ibn Hazm and Ibn Arabi and a fi'atun min al-ulama said that hadith is what? Suspended, therefore music is what? Halal, because that's the only hadith you have for music saying it's haram. But then what? Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, he mentions in his Fath al-Bari, he mentions that actually we do wasl of that hadith particularly through Az-Zarkashiyu and Al-Hamd ibn Shakir.
I think we're completely
diverging. No, sorry, sir.
All I wanted to confirm, Brother, save your time.
Yeah.
You don't believe Allah's, when we say
you're going,
the safat of Allah's hand, that it's not a physical, literal hand.
No one's saying something is physical.
It,
Allah,
that's it. That's all I wanted to hear from you.
But here's what I want to say to you. The point is, Al-Bukhari, which goes against what I would say some muta'asibin say, okay? From the Ash'aris, I'm gonna be very clear. Just like there's muta'asibin from the Taymites, because that's what they are, akhi. Some people, they follow Ibn Taymiyyah as if he's al-mumathil al-rasmi lil-Sunni Islam, which he's not.
Of course.
And he makes mistakes, and this is gonna be a shock.
Do you believe that he made taqiyah when he claimed to have repented?
No, I don't know.
No.
I think that he made mistakes when it comes to issues.
You know, when he repented in public, do you believe that was
I don't know.
Everyone knows that he made a supposed repentance, whether or not it was a real
I'm not gonna, look, I don't know.
I hold it to be genuine.
Yeah. I don't think Ibn Taymiyyah, yes, is mumathil rasmi al-Sunni Islam.
You don't believe
Islam.
He died as an Ash'ari, no?
No.
Because he made repentance in Cairo, according to historians.
This kalam is quite sathi, akhi.
I just stated that Ibn Taymiyyah in Cairo repented according to historians. Whether or not you believe it was genuine.
I don't know,
genuine,
akhi. I don't know what repentance.
I
haven't looked into it. It's not my bath. It's not my carry. I don't care about. Here's what I'm saying. If you say to me Ibn Taymiyyah, I'm not here to defend Ibn Taymiyyah. Sorry. I'm really not. I'm not saying that I love Ibn Taymiyyah. I think he's a Muslim and a Sunni Muslim, and the one who made many arguments, which I think a lot of Ash'aris would disregard because of maybe a polemical position, just in the same way as many Atharis would disregard Al-Ghazali for a polemical position. But what I would say is, he made mistakes. And that's something that you won't hear many people saying. For example, he made mistakes in fiqhiyat. For instance, in the Hanbali fiqh, three talaq in one majlis. That's khilaf al-jumhur, and so on and so forth.
We're on the same page about Ibn Taymiyyah.
Maybe we are, maybe not. Just to finish off, what I was going to say to you is this. The end, khulasat al-qawl, is that if you look at the kalam of the salaf, I'm going to sound a bit like Shamsi here, isn't it? But when I say salaf, I'm not talking about Rabi' al-Madkhali. Okay, I'm talking about the actual Salaf. Salaf al-Salih. I'm talking about the Sahaba and those who came after them and those who came after them. If you look at the kalam of those individuals, including al-Bukhari, who done compilations, including al-Harb al-Kirmani, who had mistakes as well, I'm not going to say he was, Ibn Khuzaymah, who had his mistakes as well, I'm not saying he did. But if you look at that kalam, their position is khilaf, the later Ash'ari position on issues to do with Alu, in my opinion. That is qat'i. In the sense that they would say Allah is above the throne. You wouldn't say Allah is above the throne in kalam that is different if you're an Ash'ari. You would use the same exact kalam of the Quran. But if you say that Allah is above the throne, yes, you're making a statement. Where is Allah? Is that a legitimate question? So obviously Ash'ari will say, لَيْسَ لَهُ مَكَانٌ أَوْ زَمَانٌ. But then the Salaf didn't say this. The Salaf said that Allah is above the throne. The Sahaba said that. And so did the people that came after them and the people that came after them. And that can easily be shown. Do you see what I'm trying to say? So that's why I'm saying that the question of, this is the Ash'ari position, and this is the Athari, and this is, no. There's a nice intersection between the two. And there are people with maturity.
But when you're referring to the people of the Salaf who said this, do you believe that they literally believed Allah was physically above His arsh?
No one says physically. We say bidatihi.
Therefore, when the Ash'ari say Allah exists without a place, but then the early Salaf said Allah is above His throne. That in reality, both opinions are correct.
No. They're not correct. Let me explain why.
So, because when the Ash'ari say Allah exists without a place, meaning Allah has no fixed physical abode.
No. But right? Let me explain. Now, even according to Al-Juwayni, now you must have read the works of Juwayni, because he's the...
I've read some of
his books. Yes, Amlaq. Oh, and in my opinion, he is the Shakhsi al-Mihwari. Right. Did you get me? Now, Al-Ghazal...
Muhammad Hijab, I've come here just to find out what you believed about Allah's hand.
But, yes.
Your answer suffices for me.
Yes, okay.
Right?
Jazakumullah khairan.
And my opinion is not required for you either way. Yes. It's just I wanted to hear.
Yeah, khalas.
Okay? And that's it. That's what I wanted to hear.
Alhamdulillah.
Of course, who are we to be discussing disagreements for 1400 years? Right?
Yeah, exactly.
Because the ulama have been doing it for years.
Yes.
We're not ulama. You have more knowledge than me.
No.
But we're not ulama, and we shouldn't be discussing these topics in front of the park. I went against my own usul last time talking to Ali Dawah. I shouldn't have discussed it in the first place. So I just wanted to hear what you believe, because you claim to be an Athari. And now I understood your
opinion. Here's what I claim to be. I claim to be someone. When it comes to aqaid, I claim to be someone who tries to follow the Sahaba. Why? Because the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, "Khayrul Qurun Qarni, thumma ladina yulunahum, thumma ladina."
Now you have to claim that.
So when it comes to masail of asma' or sifat, for me the best and safest opinion is to go to what the awwalun said. I literally go to those books. I don't care what. Ibn Taymiyyah. He died 728, akhi.
We know.
He died 728, A-H.
Ibn Taymiyyah is not really relevant to this discussion.
So, exactly. Shukran. Wa shukurak. Habibi.
Jazakallah khairan. It's nice to meet you.
Thank you very much.
Can I ask a question?
We're going to pray with Maghrib. Sir, you want to come pray with us?
It could pray 4 minutes.
No, I have to pray for...